Hello and welcome to another episode of GDL-IL, GDL Israel. Today we're going to keep it real condensed and speak about few HTML5 APIs or features that you could leverage and use today. Some of them I find are really simple to implement and could save you lots of unnecessary work. And I think the line that just connect all of them is that they got some nice adoption today in different browsers, and you could definitely leverage them and use them. And those APIs, or in a way, the browser features will enable you to save code, which is always great because less code, less time need to spend reading it, maintaining it, etc. And in some of them, it's just a better way or more efficient way to do things. So let me just share my screen with you. And actually, the demo that I prepared is live. So you are more than welcome to go to my site and just play with the page itself. All the code is on the page, and all the code snippets are gist. So you could check them on GitHub or on my page. Let me share my screen. And yeah, hopefully you could see it quite clearly. DevTool as well. Just so you could see, and maybe we'll throw the dev tool just to the bottom because we don't need the real estate of the page itself. I'll make everything much bigger, so hopefully code easily. And basically, as you could see now, we have a few examples here, and we could probably start with the most basic one, the geolocation. So the geolocation API is with us for a long time. And if you want to see on which browsers this nice feature will be supported, you could check it on the search box that I prepared. And if you'll type here geo and click, you'll be redirected to a site that we mentioned a few times in the past, which is called caniuse.com. And on geolocation, for instance here, you could see quite clearly that the current version of browsers, basically it's supported on all the browsers, so IE, Firefox, Chrome, Safari, and Opera on the desktop. And on the mobile arena, we have from iOS to Android quite a nice support. So it's definitely a feature that you could use. Here I just choose to show you a few interesting things. So as you could see here, we're using the Navigator geolocation to do the feature detection. So in case our browser, for some reason, the user browser is not supporting this feature, it's quite clearly that we could communicate it nicely. And since here we are all developers, I'm just using the console log, but you could do something much better when you are running your own code and communicate this information to the user. However, when we do have this feature, we're just going and calling the Navigator geolocation get current position and transferring it a callback function with the position, so we could gather the latitude, longitude of the position and then do some interesting stuff. Now, what I wanted to show you that I'm doing here, and as you could see here, I'm basically extracting the address from the geo point. And that's actually, I think, less than five lines of code in JavaScript. So let's just go here and see how it will look like. And if we'll open the source, and I just put all the source code of this page in our main page, let's do it here and see here. Let's not check the iframe that I embedded from GitHub. Let's just see the code itself of our page. And here in our page itself, I could in DevTool click Command F, search for geo. And check. And in our case, it will be in this div. And what we're basically doing here is just going, and in this script, we're calling basically Google Maps API. Now you could see here, I'll make the code easier. What I'm doing here is just going to the geo location, and once I have the point itself, I'm just going to Google Map API and transfer to it just here the longitude, latitude, and the geopoint that I built from those two parameters. And with sensor false, it could be sensor true, and then the user will need to confirm that they agree to share the location. By the way, you could see here a nice indication that you see this page is tracking your location, so the user need to approve it for the first time. And once we're doing that, let's get back to our code. Just over here in the script, we are going here and going and get the JSON, so we'll get an array of results from Google Map API, and in our little case, I'm running on each and every result here, and as you can see here, I'm printing the different results to the console, and for our little example, I just choose the first result, which usually will be with the highest quality, and I'm just outputting to the screen right here. So geolocation is one neat API that you could leverage today. Another very cool one is the summary object. So today, without any JavaScript, you could play and get this summary detail aspect of things without any line of JavaScript. And if we'll go here and do inspect element, basically you could see that you could tell the browser that you have here an element. It's not a div, it's detail an element. And a summary, which basically giving you the header or the main title of this element. And then you could expand and collapse it just by clicking on it. So it's very nice. Here, as you can see, I just put a paragraph in it to explain it. But really sweet and short ability to work with the HTML markup and tell the browser exactly what we want. And in this case is, of course, an expandable div that shouldn't be just a div with a JavaScript that's running on it, but rather just to communicate and using the right elements, and in this case it's detail and summary. Local storage is another one very simple API that I highly encourage you to check. The code snippet here is so simple, so you could understand that it's really the most basic one. And one important thing to note about this API that is synchronous and not asynchronous. So it's better to use few keys with large payload in the value, and then it will be more efficient. Or if you have the need to do it asynchronously and use lots of data, probably check out IndexedDB, which will work much better and give you a full-blown database and not just a key value API like local storage. Now with local storage, you're just calling it with set item and you have immediately the key value. And to retrieve, you just need to go to local storage with the right key and you'll retrieve the answer. One nice thing here that I prepared is just, you could see that I wrote it in Hebrew, but we could, for the example, say something like, hey and bye, store it. And after we do that, if we'll go with the key of, here it's meaning in Hebrew, shalom, if we'll retrieve, we don't have anything, but if we'll go here and do hi and retrieve, you could see that I have bye because that's what I put it here. One nice thing to debug and see what we're doing with local storage will be to go to the resources tab. And here in the resource tab, you can see here that in local storage, I basically have a nice view of the keys and the value. And if I'll put here some more, let's do I haul and let's save it. So you can see here that I have now another element, and very simple and easy to work with this nice API, especially if you want to debug it through leveraging Chrome DevTools. Another nice option is WebRTC. Now, I'm sure some of you noticed that the browser is notifying me here that this specific domain, which I'm holding all my projects, ido-green.appspot.com, want to use my camera. Now, in this case, of course, I will allow it because I know who and why we want to do it. And if we'll go to the WebRTC example, and we'll close the DevTool for a second, one, you could see that the page containing moi. And the other nice point is that the code to do so is very, very simple and trivial. First, we're just getting hold of our get user media. And for the ones that doesn't know, if we search here quite quickly, web art, you could see that we're supporting Let's do web. So get user media, which is the right way to call it, will be supported in the near future on IE11. And it's currently supported on Firefox, Chrome, and Opera. So when we're going to our code, you could see that I'm calling get user media. Hopefully it will be the standard and all the browsers will support it. And for now, I'm checking and making sure that I get a hold through the prefixes of WebKit and Moz for Firefox. Once I do that, I have here my callback, and this callback is basically being set it here, and the error callback to just make sure that we are communicating right now to ourselves what's happening in case that things are not going smoothly, and a few constraints. So in our case, we'll just do the video capturing, but you could do it with audio as well. Now on the success callback, I basically have the local media stream that I'm just attaching to a variable, and then in my case, I have a video tag that now I'm getting hold on, and this video tag, I'm basically taking the video source, and that's one of the beauty in this API that basically we're leveraging the same good old attributes that we had in the video element. And here in video source, I could just attach to it instead of just an MP4 file, I'm just attaching this local media stream. And by doing so, I'm just creating a URL object that will able to stream it to the video element. And when I'm clicking play, basically the result here is that you could see and work with this stream for your usage. Visibility API is actually a very nice API that gets you the ability to see what the users are actually exposing to in your current tab or window. So when the user is flipping, and you could see here that I flipped several times from can I use and back to our page. Each time I did so, a new event was triggered. And right now I just put it on the page itself so you could all see it. But you could imagine that you could stop the video playing, for instance, or do other clever things when the users are not really paying attention or are focusing on the current tab or window that you are doing. In order to get this, we're just attaching a listener to the visibility change, and then we could do whatever we like. I also put here a nice tutorial that my colleague Joe Marnak wrote, giving you a very nice capability of how to use this nice API. Device orientation, of course, as you all know, on mobile devices, we have the ability to work with the accelerometer and get what the device itself is doing now in a 3D environment. And we got those three params on the alpha, beta, and gamma axles. And basically, this API is really nice if you are developing any web app that will want to use or leverage the capabilities of the mobile browsers or on the tablet or on phones. I think we covered most of the things that I wanted here. And as I promised, today we'll keep it real short. And if there's any question on HTML5 APIs, please feel free to reach out to me on plus.google.com/plus-ido-green or on Twitter @green-ido as one word. And if some of the viewers got some question right now, please feel free to ask. Let's see if we have some questions on the chat. No, we don't. So until next time, be strong and safe, and see you.